Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about setting up Microsoft ADFS, which stands for Active Directory Federation Services. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about setting up Active Directory Federation Services. The reason that I am doing this is because I received an email from Frank Jr., and he was like, yo, I'm curious, do you have any videos dealing with Microsoft ADFS? And I went to my channel, I searched for ADFS, because if I had something, I copy and paste it and send it and I'm done. And it was zero. I didn't have anything. So I said to myself, I need to create something. So this is the reason why I'm doing this video. So first things first, on the desktop, I'm going to right click on the start menu, go to run, type in WinVer, hit OK. So I'm running my entire environment within Windows Server 2019 version 1809. So on the desktop, I'm going to click on start, and within start, I'm going to right click on Windows PowerShell, then go to more. Within here, I'm going to click on run as an administrator. And within the command prompt, I am going to type in the following. I am going to type in install Windows feature, and the feature that we are going to install is ADFS-Federation with a parameter of include management tools, hit enter. It's going to start collecting the data, install all the features, and you're done. We're going to close out PowerShell, click on start, click on server manager. And once server manager is up and running, on your upper right corner, you're going to see an exclamation point with a flag. So we're going to click on that guy, and you're going to see a post deployment configuration setting for your Active Directory Federation Services. So we are going to click on configure the Federation service on this server. You're going to get the wizard. I'm going to leave everything as the default. I do want to create the first Federation server in a Federation server farm, and we are going to click on next there. I'm going to leave the default as the current user, but you are able to change it. Click next. And now for the SSL certificate, I actually purchased an SSL certificate for this video, which was really cheap. It's not that bad. So the way that I got the SSL certificate is I installed IIS, as you guys can see right here on the server. I actually have IIS installed. And within there, within the server SSL certificate node, you're able to create a CSR request. Take that gibberish. You can place it anywhere. GoDaddy, Komodo, wherever you're going to get an SSL certificate. It's going to generate the SSL certificate. Once you get that, you're going to download it, and then you're going to import it inside the IIS manager. Hopefully, you guys know how to do that. If not, let me know, and I will do a video on that. Now, I already imported my SSL within this server, and if I click on the drop-down menu, I'm going to see the SSL certificate that I imported inside this machine. So I'm going to select it, and automatically the Federation service name will be pre-populated for you. And then you're going to give it a service display name, which I gave it BTNHD Labs. Clicked on next there. Now, you're going to get this nice little warning. If you click on show more, it's going to give you information. Now, it gives you the warning of group managed service account are not available because of the KDS root key has not been set. Press OK there. Open up PowerShell. I'm going to show you guys how to set it. You're going to run the following command of add-KDS root key with a parameter of effective immediately. Hit enter. Now, if you go back, go to previous, and then go next again, you're going to see that create a group managed service account is enabled. Now, for this video, I'm not going to use that option. I'm actually going to use an existing domain user account or group managed service account. So I'm going to click on select. I'm going to provide a user account. Click OK. You're going to provide your account password. Once you're done there, click on next. It's going to take you here. From here, you have an option to actually create a database using a Windows internal database, or if you have a SQL Server database, you are able to configure it that way. So I'm going to leave it as the default, which is actually using Windows internal database, and then click next. From here, we are going to click on next. All the prerequisites checked out with no problem, and then click on configure. I did get a couple of warnings. I need to look up why I got these warnings, but I was still able to sign in within the ADFS sign-in website. One of the warnings is that you need to restart your machine. Now, before you close and restart your machine, I created an A record of ADFS because that's actually the SSL certificate. That is the Federation service name that I created. So I just make sure I created a record as well as created an associated pointer record and just click add host. Everything was created successfully. Awesome. And just restart your machine. Once you restart your machine, log back in, you're inside Server Manager. And what you want to do is open up your favorite browser. I open up Chrome and you want to type in the following address. So again, adfs.btnhd.com and all this stuff next to it. This information, I actually got it within the Microsoft Technic site. So when I hit enter, I was like, oh, okay, got it. It's loaded up. No problem. I didn't get that 404 error message with a web page, but I got this. An error occurred. Okay. Oh, what happened? So I clicked on error details and I got all this gibberish. So I'm saying, what the hell is this? This is alien talk, right? So I clicked on a start menu. I went to Windows Administrative Tools, and I know that the ADFS has its own management. So I found the Active Directory Federation Service Management, and I clicked on it. And it looks like I needed to add a trusted relying party. So that's the only thing that's incomplete. So I clicked on that. I followed the prompts. I left everything as the default. Clicked on start here. For my Federation address, I added the adfs.btnhd.com. Hit next there. I left the display name as the default. Clicked on next. And then you're able to actually choose the access control policy. Now, by default, I think it's actually set as to permit everyone. I recommend that you go over all the policies and configure it the way that you want it within your 9-to-5 environment. But for now, for this video, I'm leaving it as permit everyone and then click next. You have ready to add the trust. I will recommend going to each tab, making sure everything looks good within your environment. And once you're done, click on next, and then you're able to close and then done. So I went back to the site, refresh, and I still got the same problem. So I said to myself, what is going on? So it looks like that web page that we're trying to access or sign into is disabled by default. Now, if you run the following command within PowerShell and you hit enter, it's going to state false, right? Because that's what Microsoft stated on their site. By default, that page is turned off. Don't know why. Now, to turn it on, it's pretty easy. You're going to run the following command and just make sure you set it to true. Hit enter. If you run the same command that we did at the very beginning to check the value and you hit enter, it's going to say true. Now, if you open up your browser and you go back inside that URL, you should work. Now, I used Internet Explorer. It doesn't really matter which one you use. The only reason that I use Internet Explorer because Internet Explorer actually allows me to add a local intranet, and I added my web address, which is https://adfs.btnhd.com. So I added that within the intranet. That's actually one of the recommendations that Microsoft added within their site. So once I did that, I went back inside the page. This looks good. I didn't get an error. Awesome. I clicked on sign in. And once I'm signed in, it says you are signed in. Awesome. Again, this is only the setup and configuration part, just the installation part of basically Active Directory Federation Services. I'm not going to kill this machine as of yet because I might play with it a little bit more and see what else I could do with this guy. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.